King Solomon tells us, wisdom is the principal thing, therefore get wisdom. As we seek this wisdom, let us turn to the church fathers and say, Abba, give me a word that I may live. In Micah chapter 7, verse 8, we read, Do not rejoice over me, my enemy. When I fall, I will arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord will be a light to me. This short passage is an encouraging passage that we can try to memorize, because oftentimes we find ourselves in our weakness falling into various sins, some of which turn into habits. And in these times when many of us are in isolation and have a bit more time to spend in our homes, with our families, and even with ourselves, we find ourselves also discovering certain sins, certain weaknesses that perhaps we did not realize we had. All of a sudden, maybe I'm short-tempered, I'm yelling, I'm getting angry. Or maybe I find certain sins that I had overcome many years ago begin to resurface. And in the midst of all these sins or this discovery, we find at times the enemy convincing us to lose hope in ourselves, to lose hope in achieving victory over our sins, and to even refrain from standing before our Lord to pray because of the shame we feel. But we must remember that we are indeed sinners and we continuously fall, yes, but we must also learn to rise, as Micah tells us, when I fall, I will arise. And so we don't allow the enemy to rejoice. And we must also remember that in the midst of darkness, of sin, our unshakable hope in God and in His mercy will protect us. No matter the number, no matter the greatness or severity of our sins, nothing can prevail over God's wonderful compassion and loving kindness. And for this reason, I must turn to the true light that destroys darkness. I must turn to God in prayer. Saint John of Dalyatha, or the spiritual elder, teaches us in letter 43 this very wisdom, when he explains that Satan binds us as if with chains and enslaves us to sin. But then he speaks of the power of repentance and says to us about those who repent, their chains are broken and their adversities are changed into joy and their tears into great rejoicing. He who had bound them is himself bound by the reins of darkness and delivered by them to the scourgers. Repentance destroys all his works and all the pains he causes the servants who are not his. She heals and restores all whom he has killed. She resuscitates all his traps. She shatters and all his snares she cuts to bits. She makes fornicators virgins. How beautiful this passage of Saint John of Dalyatha. No matter what our sins are or how ashamed we may be of them, here Saint John of Dalyatha teaches us that repentance heals and restores, that repentance has the power over the enemy and destroys the enemy and transforms us, frees us, and gives us life. Let us learn to repent and not delay. Let us learn that even if I was deceived into committing a sin or have been committing sins habitually, let me not be deceived into despair by not praying, but rather let me turn to God in repentance and in prayer. Let us pray with Saint John of Dalyatha this final prayer. I have no tears of supplication, Lord. I have no contrite heart for seeking you. I have not the repentance and compunction that turns sons back to their inheritance. My intellect is darkened through the things of this world and has not the strength to lift its gaze towards you with mourning. My heart has grown cold through a multitude of evils and cannot become warm through tears of love. O Christ, treasure of all goodly things, grant me perfect repentance and an aching heart that comes out in love to seek you. Amen.